There's a great difference, C.S. Lewis explains, between love and being in love. Being in love is a feeling. Love is an action. Love is an action that moves out of itself towards the other. It is incredibly important that our modern society understands this distinction, because we've come to believe that the only real foundation of a marriage is the emotion of being in love. That's a dangerous thing to do, and you can see that it's not working because divorce is 50% or whatever it is in our country. Many people think that the foundation of love is this storm of emotions, being in love and having my needs met and all that sort of stuff. The trouble with that is that what happens if that feeling goes away? Does that mean that the marriage is now illegitimate? Does that mean that the vows we took no longer mean anything? No, it doesn't. It is wonderful when the feeling of being in love accompanies the action of love, but it's not the same thing. Now, Lewis says, what do you do? Let's say it from the man's point of view. What does the man do if he no longer feels love for his wife, no longer feels the emotion of being in love with his wife? Well, Lewis counsels this. Start treating your wife as if you loved her. Practice the action of love. Move outward towards her. And you know what? If you treat her in a loving way, eventually the loving feelings will return. The same is true for a wife who no longer respects her husband. Wives, start treating your husband as if you respect him, and soon the feeling of respect will return. This is not only vital if we're going to keep our marriages alive and together in this divorce culture in which we're immersed. It's also important if we're to understand Jesus' command to love our enemies. Love your enemy does not mean feel warm feelings towards your enemy. That is impossible. Of course we don't feel warm fuzzies towards our enemy. They're our enemy. When Jesus says love your enemy, he means treat them with love. Now, if you treat them with love, then you might, I don't think you'll have warm fuzzies if they're your enemy, but you might be able at least to feel pity and some emotion rather than just hatred and anger and bitterness. Perhaps more importantly, when we give charity, too many people in our country have this idea that it's only truly charity if we hate it. Okay, if you truly practice charitable behavior towards people, soup kitchen, whatever it is, truly practice the virtue or action of love, sooner or later you will start feeling loving feelings towards those people. And if you don't, if you work at a soup kitchen for 10 years and still feel no love, there's a problem there. You're probably really not practicing the virtue of charity or love.